Jester Show, another Jester season. We're going to do a little bit of improv in this show. What is improv, you might ask? Improv is made up right here on the spot with suggestions from you, the coaches. That's right. The opposing team's coaches are giving the suggestions to the team that they're facing in this show. So, obviously, that's a little untraditional in the way we normally do it, but that's how we're doing it this year, at least while we're online. There are two rules we got to make sure that we follow. The first rule, of course, is that groan or foul. Say it and do that gesture with me. It is a groan or foul. That's if someone's up here to say something that's kind of dad jokey, kind of punny. If it's over the top dad jokey, we will call that foul. You will see it happen in the video, and we're just calling attention to that joke. The last foul is if they cross that line from a dad joke or a groan. So a little bit more serious, something maybe we shouldn't put on YouTube. That is called our potty mouth foul. You will see this digitally imposed toilet seat that I hope we figure out and is on my neck as we speak, and we'll put that over their video when they actually do it. So let's stop wasting time with me. Let's get to some improv.
The show, gawking at the tricks of your sleeve. Too good to be truthful. I'm in a room full of entertainers and thieves. You used to let it go.
Jackson, please join me. Captain Jonathan, please join me. Wave to the fans. Wave to all of the people lined up in the bleachers waiting for your autographs. Very good. Very good. You did good. So this is where we come to our captain's challenge. It's an equivalent of like a jump ball or a coin toss. This is where I put my improv skills to the test, and I make up a challenge for our captains right on the spot. Now, here's the neat thing, the interesting thing. Pahrump is in a different school district than CCSD. So Pahrump right now, they're on spring break. To where Jonathan here was literally doing homework up till the moment he jumped into this captain's challenge. So I want them to compare their days in this captain's challenge, but I want them to compare their days Shakespearean style. So they are going to Shakespearean style navigate what they did today to just compare and contrast. I'm going to start with Jonathan. In your best Shakespearean speaking voice, navigate your day for us. Begin.
Thy day started on a non-spring break evening. I woke up late, or thy eye had broke up way too late for class, showed up late and went, "Oh no, sorry about that, Miss Cheetah." And then all of a sudden, she revealed a tardy slip. Whoa, this midsummer evening, skull, that is my own deep reflection.
Okay, Jackson, in your best Shakespearean thing, describe your day thus far and begin.
To get out of bed or not to get out of bed, that is the question. I arise from my slumber to get some food to ease my hunger. But not any regular food would do. It had to be amazing. So I got my food. And oh god, this is hard.
We can pause it there. That's all right.
Then I postponed doing my project over the weekend.
As we all do on spring break. As we all do. Well, I got to pick one of the two of you. And I don't know. Jackson seemed like he rhymed. And Jonathan got a tardy slip. So I have to reward Jackson and not Jonathan, because that's good reward ship. So, winner of the coin toss is Pahrump. Let's watch some improv games right now.
There you go.
Yeah. Next game there is a disease called Carbon Copy, or Clones. The way this game goes, you'll see one scene set up, and then the next scene will be a copy of the first scene. And this will happen on over and over and over throughout time. As we know, when we take copies of pictures and papers, the more copies that we take of it of a copy of a copy, it's copycatted to the copy. So it's going to be distorted and mixed up and different from the other. So this is your game of Carbon Copy.
Step right up. I have your designated jobs. You, that person in the distance. Oh, you look like a person. Now, what is it that could be your job? Come over here. Tell us something about you.
Well, I've been living on a farm for most of my life, except the other day, I accidentally left the pig pen open, and they all kind of ran out, they all just left, and so my dad fired me, and now I'm homeless, and don't really have a job, and I'm looking for a job.
Oh, that's very funny. Well, it just so happens, what did you say your name was?
My name's Samantha.
Samantha, well, you are a pig. Now, what a coincidence is that?
Is that an insult?
No, it's what, you want to read it? It says pig. Now, you saw it. Now it says pig. Now, yeah. Oh!
Okay.
You have owners now.
Oh, joy. I guess that means I have a home that is...
Yes, it does. You will be eating slop and whatever else they give you for the rest of your life. Aren't you excited?
You know, now, hey there, I overheard your name was Samantha. You know, I've been to this club fair for a while now, and I just like to say, you know what? What's your name again?
Samantha.
Wonderful to meet you. Well, I'm a professional dad. I'll be anyone's dad for any amount of money. I'm just a nice little folk over here. So you know what? I got your back, okay? Okay, Samantha? My name is Dad. It's actually Dad. I legally changed it to D-A-D. And you know what? It looks like this man is being a little bit mean to you.
Listen, I am the great Gangini, and I know everything. Now, when I say someone is a pig, they are a pig.
Well, I mean,
I'm a T-Rex. I got evicted from my time.
See?
Anyway.
look at this T-Rex over here. Now, they were once a person, and then they went through the Great Gangini, got their job assignment. They're T-Rex.
And I'm Dad.
Scene.
Step right up. It's me, the Great Gangini, and I shall give you your job assignments. You there, person all the way in the back. Come right up. Tell us something about you, and I will give you your job.
Well, hello. My name is Samantha, and you see, I was working at a farm with my family, except one day I kind of left the pig pen open, and then all the pigs ran out, and my dad fired me, and now I'm homeless, and I just really need a job, you know?
Fired from your own father. How pathetic. Well, that fits your job description quite well, because it turns out you'll be a pig. It says right there. Now, you saw it. You're going to be a pig now.
Is that an insult?
Well, it's the truth in many aspects.
No, jeepers creepers, he is not a keepers. Okay, so, I know I'm a random folk around here. I've been to this club for many years, club fair, whatever. What's your name? Can I get it for you?
My name is Samantha.
Samantha, I'm shaking your hand, really. No, come on, shake your hand. Okay. Well, now, my name is Dad. D-A-D. I'm just Dad. I'm everyone's dad. That's my job. And it looks like this man, he's not being very nice to you.
No, he's not.
Wow. Well, we gotta do something about that.
Excuse me, but I am the great Gangini. And if you don't appreciate my amazing words and job choices, then I don't think you should be talking to me right now.
Hey, what's up? I'm a T-Rex.
Look at another happy customer. This person was not a person anymore because they're a T-Rex because I told them to, because I am the great Gangini, and look at how happy they are.
Well, I'm the great dad. Yeehaw.
Everyone step right up. I am the great Gangini, and I shall give you your job assignments. You there, person yes. in the back. Yes, you. What? Come up here. Tell us what you are.
Okay. Well, my name is Samantha. You see, I was working. I worked at a farm, and I worked with my whole family. He said one day I let the freaking pig pen open, and then all the pigs escaped, and my dad was like, "You can't live here anymore. Go away." And so now I'm homeless and jobless, and I need a job real bad.
What a loser. Well, lucky for you, I have a job fit enough for a loser like you. Let's see here. Oh, Samantha, Southern loser. Oh, you're gonna be a pig. Oh, how marvelous. Oh, aren't you excited to eat slop for the rest of your life, poor little piggy?
Is that an insult?
Oh, it's true in many aspects, darling.
Now, there's no wiping. Come on, because I'll be beeping. Okay. So now I've been to this club fair for many years by now, okay? So my name is Dad, D-A-D, you know, I'm getting ahead of myself. What's your name?
My name is Samantha.
Samantha, shake my hand. You know what, come on, bear hug. There we go. Okay, so now it looks like we're going into a bit of a kerfuffle. A little bit of a kerfuffle. So I just want to make sure that you're okay, and I'll be your dad because my job is a professional dad. So I got your back. If you need help going back to this mean man, I'll be your dad to the end.
Excuse me, but I am the great Gangini, and I have given my job assignment, and she must carry out this job to the end of her life.
Samantha, you do whatever your heart and little desires. Your little heart, your brave big heart. Get behind me, Samantha!
I smell piggies.
Look at this happy cousin. This is what I can do. This was once a person, now a T-Rex! All thanks to the powers of the mighty Gangini!
He may be a T-Rex, but I sure am D-A-D Dad!
I am the great Gangini! I will give everyone their job assignments and all shall obey my word. You there! You in the back! What are you? I will give you your life's purpose!
Hello, my name is Samantha! And you see, guess what? Guess what happened to me? You won't believe it. Oh my god!
What happened, Samantha?
So I worked on a farm with my family, with my mom and my dad, but most importantly, my dad. And you see, one day, I was so tired, I wasn't thinking, and I left the pig pen open, and all the pigs ran free, and now my dad fired me, and now I don't have a job, and I'm jobless and homeless.
Wow, you sure sound pathetic and like a loser. Yeah, that's really unfortunate for you, but I don't care. I have your job assignment, Samantha. Your life will be so much better. Your job assignment is a pig. Oh, you want to see? That's what it says. It's a pig. You're a pig now. I even have a collar for you.
Is that an insult?
It's inaccurate in many ways. You shall spend the rest of your life eating slop like you deserve.
Oh boy, hey, it looks like you little girl down there, it looks like you need a glad dad. Oh, scrapers. Wow. Okay, you know what? You know what you need? You may think that you need a biscuit, but you just need a good old dad brisket. You know, I've been to this club so many times, and I love it. I love it. You know what? My job is a professional dad. You know what? I didn't even give a welcome. Your name is what? Samantha, I already know.
Oh.
You don't have to worry about that. Now give me a good old bear hug. Bear hug. Please. Okay, cool. Now, it looks like you little girl down there, I see you. You're strong, you're powerful, but you know what you need? You need a stuffed animal, and you need to tell this man no, there you go. Tell this man how you feel.
I'm sad.
Yeah.
I am the great Gambini. No matter what your made-up father says, you cannot deny your job. You are a pig now.
I got you.
Another happy non-customer that I made into a T-Rex. This was once a person, and look at how they're living out their life's purpose. Terrorizing random people. They are living the best life they could probably live. All thanks to me.
Well, thanks to me, Samantha's gonna be safe, because if I'm not, they Mr. One Time Best-Selling Variety Magazine's number one bestsellers, Dad of the Year.
Scene.
Yeah. Next game that's going to be played is called Chamber. The way the game goes, one person will be given an occupation, a location, and a murder weapon. It is then up to them to use pantomime or gibberish to explain who they are, where they are, and what weapon they're using of choice to the next person, but only using pantomime and gibberish. Once the next person they're explaining it to gets a kind of a gist or idea what the person is, where they are, and what weapon they're using, they will then use that weapon to kill the person that's explaining to them who they are. They'll then pass on that information to the next person, to the next person. It's kind of like the game Telephones. Once they come up with an idea of what they are, where they are, what weapon they're using, that is the game. Chain Murder.
Ba ba ba.
Gabby.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Okay.
Whoa, boom, ba, boom. Wah, boom, boom, man.
Ba, boom, ba.
Ooh.
Booba, gooba. Mm, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, okay, okay,
okay. So, okay.
Galalala? Oh, yeah, they're going dundo. Hello. Okay.
Not my surprise witness. Okay, Juliet, I think we have all the information we need, but can you confirm for us once and for all who was the murderer?
I can sure try. A Martian.
And where was this murder taken?
Well, as he was a Martian, clearly on Mars.
That is correct. And what was the murder weapon?
A lightsaber?
That it was not. We still need the true murderer and the murder weapon. Ryan, can you confirm what it was?
I mean, I got the Martian part. That was pretty easy.
So who was the murderer and what was the murder weapon?
Murderer was some kind of beast. I don't know which one. Although there's a lot of things that are defined as beasts that are not.
Give it a guess. And just throw something out there.
Like a lion or something.
Okay. And the weapon?
The weapon was like a bat or like some sort of like swinging thing.
That is not correct either. Isabella, can you clarify this information?
All right. So I thought that the person was a lion who's also a chef, like a culinary lion.
Okay.
And then, I mean, I thought it was the moon, but Mars works too. Like, I knew it was in space. And then I thought the murder weapon was dry spaghetti noodles.
Sadly not. That is a good guess for a food that breaks, though, before you eat it. Jackson, can you give us the true answers to this crime?
Yes, Detective, I have your answers. The murderer was Bowser from Mario.
My favorite chef.
The murder location was Mars.
That's correct.
And the weapon was a Kit Kat candy bar.
And there you have it.
Afraid of changing, cause I
extravagant! Our next game is going to be What Else You Got? Here's how that works. So, we're going to have two people. people up here, and one of them's gonna get a motion given to them by the opposing team's coach, okay? And they're going to start doing that motion, whatever it is. And the other person's going to copy that motion. Then the person who started the motion is gonna say, hey, I'm doing the motion, what else you got? At which point, the copier is going to have to come up with something that looks like that motion, but is not actually the thing they originally said. At which point they're going to say, what else you got? And keep going back and forth, to one that gets eliminated. The way you get eliminated is if they repeat a motion that's already been used, if they hesitate too long, or if what they say just doesn't jive with what they're actually doing. This is a game of what else you got? Show me, baby!
I'm flipping pancakes. What else you got?
I'm turning burgers. What else you got?
I'm fighting with someone, so I'm like punching him in the stomach to get him off guard and then hitting him with that right hook, you know? What else you got?
Well, I was in prison for embezzlement, so I'm just like sharpening my shiv just in case, you know, something comes up. What else you got?
My plants, they look so unhappy. So I have this shovel and I'm taking out the soil and replacing it with like new and fresh soil so that, you know, they'll be happy and they'll grow and stop being yellow. What else you got?
Well, I am out of jail now because I was on good behavior and not because I threatened people. And now I'm actually getting my first paycheck and I'm just so happy about it. I'm so shaky. What else you got?
All right, well, I'm lighting fireworks, but you see, they kind of need, like, a jump start, so I'm, like, lighting it and then tossing it into the air so they can, like, get going, you know? What else you got?
Well, I'm just picking up all these fireworks that some jerk just threw onto my lawn since they didn't feel like cleaning them up afterwards and just throwing them in the trash because I'm trying to be a good citizen now. Well, what else you got?
Well, unrelated to that, now I'm a cowboy, and I have a lasso, and I'm just lassoing backwards. I'm trying that technique. We'll see how it goes. What else you got?
Oh, well, I'm not having a good time in life. I'm pretty lonely, and I'm just trying to get this new app working on my phone so I can like swipe people and actually have a relationship going on. But I'm just so nervous about it that I keep accidentally throwing my phone at the ceiling and then it keeps breaking, so I gotta go buy a new phone. It's really not good. I'm losing a lot of money. What else you got?
Well, you see, my brother keeps, like, throwing their phone and breaking it. So I'm like, you know what? I'm going to try to fix it for them because they're wasting so much money on buying new ones. So I'm, like, getting the tools and all that, you know. What else you got?
Well, my sister was very nice and was fixing my phone. So I'm painting a painting for her about how great she is. And it's her working over a phone, and it's modeled after God creating Adam, you know, that painting where they're like pointing the fingers. It's modeled after that painting, but with my phone. What else you got?
Let's call it actually.
hey Nick, what are you doing?
I'm operating a forklift. Yeah. What else you got?
Oh, I'm just in a crane machine, and I'm just one of the stuffed animals that's being picked up, but I'm like just being picked up by the crane. And I'm floating up, but then I keep falling down, but then they keep going immediately right back after me because they have extra coins. You know, what else you got?
Oh, well, that's funny you say that because I'm taking a joyride around town. Because, you know, I really like this city and, you know, it's very scenic. So what else you got?
Well, you know, I showed up in a food court. And I was looking for my friends with my tray and stuff. And then I realized I had no friends and now everyone's looking at me. Oh no. And then instead of actually just sitting alone at a table and realizing that I have no friends, I need to do what's most socially acceptable. And I'm just trying to act like I'm one of those statues that just do one motion and hopefully someone puts some money on my tray. What else you got?
That's funny you ask, because personally, I think that's a great way of getting money, but I've got so much money that I am actually at a ski resort and I'm skiing. You know, woo, woo. You gotta ignore those trees, you know. What else you got?
Well, I'm Han Solo in the Millennium Falcon, but I'm on the bottom turret thing, and I'm going pew pew to TIE fighters. Wow! I hope we get out of this one. What else you got?
That's so funny you say that, cause I'm one of those stormtroopers in one of those TIE fighters, and I'm trying to chase down the Millennium Falcon, and it's so crazy I'm getting shot at. Oh no! What else you got?
Well, I'm just a dude also in the Millennium Falcon that's just like chilling up in here, and I had maracas in the cockpit, and I was shaking them a bunch, and then the driver was getting angry at me, and then he was like, "Stop shaking those maracas!" But I really like them, so I'm just quietly moving them, so I'm acting as if I am using them, but it's not making noise to bug them. Wow. What else you got?
That's so funny you say that. Because I'm reading the newspaper from a few days after that, and I'm reading how a planet got shot by the Death Star, and that's crazy. I'm so disappointed. You know, I thought we were headed towards peace, but, you know, can't always get what you want. Anyway, what else you got?
I'm just a random dude in the universe, probably on some random other planet, unrelated, but I found a swivel chair, but instead of just doing it in a side-to-side fashion, it's kind of like on a ball, so it kind of goes all around. So I'm just kind of like going, whoa, I could be a Jedi, but I'm not. That sucks. What else you got?
Scene. Cool. Let's call scene right there. Really, really good job, guys.
What are you doing?
I'm swimming. Oh. What else you got?
I am trying to jump really high because I want to be the tallest person in the world. Do you think it's working?
Sure.
Great. What else you got?
I'm praying that my grades will not flop. What else you got?
I am performing an ancient ritual so a demon can take my tests for me because I don't want to take them. And demons have been around for a while. They should be good at stuff. What else you got?
I am a pretty butterfly. What else you got?
I am dancing at a party, but I don't know how to dance, so I'm just kind of doing this in the corner, hoping everyone ignores me. What else you got?
Toning my forearms. What else you got?
I am trying to build up muscle so I can be big and
that
strong.
That sounds like toning.
I think I'm waiting for a... All right, what are you doing there?
I'm cooking, as you can see.
Oh, really? Well, I am just mixing this bowl of rocks and candy to trick the little kids into eating rocks, you see. Because I'm an evil person.
Oh, we don't. Oh, okay. I see how it is. I am mixing a potion that I have no idea what's in it. So what else you got?
Well, you see, I am just mixing together these stars because I am literally God. What wow. else you got?
Well, I'm just punching this invisible wall in front of me because I have so many issues. What else you got?
I am, well, you see, I'm doing something very confusing that I'll have to word very specifically. You see, I am hitting this book because my teacher signed it to me over spring break and I just don't want to read it. So I'm hitting it.
Well, I'm
what
here.
What else you got?
I am here swinging a sword with a shield right here, yeah, and then protecting myself. What else you got?
Well, I am definitely not running out of ideas because I am
rotating. Yay!
What are you doing?
Just picking out my pennies. How about you?
I'm flicking these cards into a wall.
Fine. I'm just picking out my favorite shirt. How about you?
I'm picking the vitamins out of this healthy meal. What are you doing?
Just giving my soul to a random stranger. How about you?
I am trying to unplug all the USBs from my computer.
Nice. I'm just donating to charity. How about you?
I am unwrapping this cord. How about you?
Wait, we already heard about unplugging and plugging.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm fixing a car. What else you got?
Oh, I'm just shining a light bulb. What else you got?
I am doing a new TikTok dance. Ooh, 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 ooh. What else you got?
I'm looking into a kaleidoscope. What else you got?
I am trying to peer my way into the future, but it doesn't seem to work. What else you got?
I'm putting dry shampoo in my hair because it's really oily. What else you got?
I'm painting a ceiling right now. What else you got?
Right now, I'm painting a ceiling too. Yeah.
That is a repeat. All right.
No matter what, got money on my mind, I can never get
sentimental. Our next game is going to be called Newscaster. Here's how it works. There's going to be a video playing that's going to be displaying some event. And it's up to the field reporter to display it to the audience. But here's the thing. Field reporter can't actually see the video. Okay, so it's going to be up to the newscasters who can see the video to help hint and guide the field reporter to saying what the video is. This is your game of field reporter. Sharon, back to you.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to our wonderful news channel. It's me, Frankie, and my co-host somewhere over here.
Hello. Hello. My name is Franklin.
Franklin.
I hired this boy. I've known him since he was born. It was great. Yeah, I've been doing this for too long. I don't know how anything works anymore.
Yeah, you know. Oh. Did you have something to say? Like, you wanted to butt in, like, right before I was going to talk, you know?
Butt in, huh?
Okay.
Back in my day, we didn't have butts. We just had perseverance.
That's wonderful, yeah. Franklin, you know, you always tell us great jokes from your time.
My time.
Your time.
Wow. You're really making me feel old.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Okay.
Seven. Come on. What are you talking about?
Old. Okay, anyway. Yeah. Anyway, I think we have some breaking information coming from one of our reporters on the ground. They should be coming around sometime soon. Who knows? you know, I mean, they might be, might not. I mean, communication
is hello! It is everybody's favorite game show host turned news reporter, Ramona Beezerson. How are y'all doing out there?
Is that a moving picture of her?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa. Back in my day, we just had hieroglyphs.
Hieroglyphs.
Well, here I am, and I'm here to give you the breaking news. Man, it's wild out here. Like, so many crazy things are happening.
I bet.
Tell us something about them.
Oh, you know, it's, you know, I'm in a place, that's for sure. I haven't had my coffee today, so my head is a little jumbled, you know.
You know, I was there a couple a while ago, you know.
A couple a while ago? Wow! Well, with how old you are, that might as well be with the dinosaurs, am I right?
Wait, what?
Huh? He's not that old. He's still got youth in his face, you know?
But yeah.
Sometimes, youth. I don't know.
Sometimes, I like the snide remarks we got here. Mm-hmm. Wow,
Okay. Any new information?
I'm the weatherman. I have important news. Pay attention to me, Peyton. Mm-hmm. My name's Jimothy, and the sun is out today.
He's right. He's good, man.
Sun's been wrong for a very long time, and the sun's been out like every day since there's been days.
Whoa.
That's insane. Crazy. That's like Alaska or something, you know, where it's like day all the time.
Sure. That's my weather report. Okay, bye.
Okay, bye. He must be a new intern. I don't know. I don't know these people.
Your report, young reporter over there.
Yes, my name is Ramona.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Loud and clear, sir.
Okay. Sorry, I just wanted to make sure you could hear me. What would you call me? I guess you can't do that. Well, can you?
I guess you can only send a telegraph at this point.
You know, back in the good old days when we didn't have phones in like the 1900s or something.
Well, you must be reporting on something about that, kind of around that area. I don't know.
Yeah, I must be. It's like the Wild West or like Victorian ages or something, you know?
Possibly. I don't know. I don't know these things. I'm just the dude who talks to the screen.
It was all in my time, but this young lad over here, this one, so I knew him since before he was born. I knew him when he was just a cell in the world. I knew him back then, so he wasn't around. He wasn't
around.
I wouldn't know
what
you're talking about.
Yeah. I was very young compared to this guy.
You know this guy.
Yeah.
I've been reporting for a long time. I'm just surprised how well you're doing with all of this. How are you doing down there? Back in this day.
Oh, you know, back in time, like millions of years ago, maybe, you know?
Whoa.
You must have gone to the wrong place.
sorry. Maybe just thousands, hundreds even.
Again, I am reasonably aged.
Okay, why? Like just a few like decades past, maybe, you know, 20s or something.
Decades, perhaps century, I guess.
Okay. Reporter person, thank you. Can you test out this wonderful new thing by sending in the first? What do they call them now?
This is spicy.
Like you're supposed to talk into the thing. It's brand new technology.
But like a phone?
Is that what they're called?
I mean we have a lot of them these days.
Days?
Well, I mean this spry young little boy over here that I practically birthed into this industry. I mean, he isn't used to that, but I mean, like, I'm sure this is pretty new for you, isn't it? Because this is. Right? Because you're back in the good old days?
I have breaking news. The weatherman, I'm his me. And I know the weather. Now, I see it, you feel before. What go on? The weather over there is dusty.
Oh, Dusty, like in the Dust Bowl? In the 30s?
1930s? A Dust Bowl doesn't sound very good. All I know is I'm 5, and the 30s, that was a long time ago. That must have been the dinosaur times.
It's almost the dinosaur times. You're a few million years off.
No, I'm white.
Yeah.
Nah.
Okay. Yeah,
if you know, you know a thing about dust, if it gets in your nose, it snows.
Snows?
It snows?
How do you go? And then yeah. You get all over the place.
That, yeah, sometimes you just get sick, and then you sneeze, because of dust everywhere.
And then,
like, there
and
was
then,
dust a long time ago.
Yeah, like with the Spanish flu, and then a lot of people weren't doing good for a while.
Which was,
But they didn't know what they could do, because...
Uh-huh.
They couldn't contact each other because they didn't know how back then.
Right.
Like, only there was some kind of invention so they could like contact each other.
Like a telegraph or something?
But more advanced if
more
only
advanced
such a thing were to exist. But I don't know. I just didn't care. Okay, that's been the weather.
Thank you, weatherman. Thank you.
I don't know that man, but I love his spirit. I love his charisma.
He's
I
so
love it.
Cute, so young and innocent.
I know. He gave a lot of good insight into where you are, didn't he? Wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
He practically took the words out of your mouth.
Practically.
I mean, how does it feel being in a kind of old but newer renaissance of creation?
You know, it's pretty great. Like, it's everyone has new ideas, and it's like an enlightenment or something.
Well, what was that again? I couldn't.
The new ideas and an enlightenment.
Precisely. I love when young folk like you get to see that all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. No, you're so right.
I mean, young boy, how does
I have some breaking news. I have breaking news. The field report, we're talking about light, the enlightenment, and the sun brings light. So I think the field reporter is at some point in time where there was a sun, because there was the lightning.
Oh my God.
There's okay, that's been the weather.
Okay, that's...
Well, that wasn't helpful at all to the news reporter. That's one bit. I can admit that right now. I'd like to just throw out a statement that's quite random. So,
go ahead.
Thank you, honey. So, I mean, this young man, he's very appreciative of the place that you are now. Because, you know, he loves talking to his friends when he's not in the same room as them. And, you know, he wouldn't be able to do that without the place that you are now. What do you have to say about that?
Phone booths these days can be super helpful. Yeah, like, just like they were back in the Enlightenment and everything. Like, you know.
I mean... Enlightenment's all about creation, am I right?
Mm-hmm.
So wouldn't you say you're kind of quite fitting all those things together?
Is there another way you could say, like, creating?
Like making?
Sort of.
Yeah.
Inventing?
Precisely. Yeah. Now, refresh my mind.
What do you think you're inventing over there?
Maybe like inventing, I don't know, like a phone booth or something.
Wow! That sounds basically what it is. You're
practically.
Yes.
We must contact our manager.
Spot on. But
see if that works out.
but let's with the entire box, and how about let's get into the nitty-gritty to make sure this man can fit it right in his pockets.
Yeah, in my pockets.
Pockets.
Phone.
Like a cell phone? The invention of a cell phone?
What? Oh my God, that's so crazy.
We gotta call Scene, don't we?
Scene! Oh,
And where are we?
So, our next game is going to be number of words. Here's how it works. Each member of Team A has been given a certain number of words to say by Team B's coach. They can only say that number of words for each sentence they have, or each time they speak a line. And we're going to see a scene about that. Here you go!
Man, I love walking in the park.
It's so very fun to walk.
Yeah, you're right, it is. It's beautiful. There's so many beautiful things in this world.
Can we leave to get ice?
Oh, I was going to say, if you want to leave to get hot dogs, I mean, we can't, but no, not that.
Ice cream is better than hot dogs.
Who says?
I says that they are better than
hot dogs. I, the ice cream salesman.
Okay, fine.
Hello, ice cream salesman. Can we get ice cream?
That depends. Do you have money? Because I'm not paying. I want hot dogs.
Well, we sell hot dog too.
I'll pay.
Ice cream hot dogs.
Even better. I'm going
perfect
to them.
Perfect combination. It's come a miraculous thing.
One or two?
7.
She's stealing money from my business.
Your business?
She didn't steal money, just the customers.
Yeah.
How will I pay rent?
Dear loyal customers.
Thank you.
Thank this you so much for never this.
Oh yeah, well, I can sell that.
Don't be better.
I don't know which one to choose. Probably
only,
the one that's
only $3 for ice cream.
Hers was $1 per hot dog.
Well, her hot dogs are lame.
They have ice cream on it.
Don't give secrets.
Can't beat that, dude.
You just gotta do better.
Maybe you should find another business.
Fine. I will find another.
Like, sell bird food or something.
Now I sell hot dog chocolate.
Sounds interesting. Wait, okay, how much?
Kinda tasty.
50 cents for hot dog chocolate.
What if?
Price?
Business?
Okay, here you go. I'll take 3.
Yes, you take 3. Now, shoo other business person.
Us partnership?
What in it for me?
Teaming up would get more money.
I am...
This is an interesting debate. Right. I need some popcorn.
I bring business.
What you say is true.
I would buy from both of you two.
I mean, I am rich.
Put on chocolate.
Yes, very intriguing.
Okay,
yes.
This is getting kind of gross. I don't want these hot dogs anymore.
No.
But these hot dogs are healthy. Yes.
How is it healthy, good sir?
It's healthy because I say so.
It's magic chocolate.
Maybe one day, girl, I pray we can flow.
Lovely. Next game to the call, horse whip. here's how it works, alright? So, the performer is going to be forming a square, however they decide to do it, alright? And each side of the square is going to be a different scene. Whichever scene's at the front is the one we're going to be seeing, okay? And we're going to rotate this square so we get to see each different side and therefore each different scene. However, we're also not that good at geometry, so this square is going to get a little jumbled up. I'm going to be seeing the characters from one scene interact with characters from another scene. So let's see how it goes!
Now, hey there. You're a student. You've been going here for a while. You must know me as Mr. Principal Elbow Patch.
Hi.
You know, because of the lack of elbow patches.
Oh.
It's iconic.
Yeah.
Now, you've been going to night school for so long, right? How has it been?
Well, in the 4 years I've been here, it's been very grueling and stressful, but it's taught me much about chivalry and honor.
Switch left?
Oh, hello there, child. What are you doing at this giant store that is unnecessary?
It's, well, you see, I had a bunch of friends come over and, like, they wanted to go get spooked, but, like, I'm real chill, so I don't really think I'm gonna get spooked anytime soon.
Well, I shall be your guide through the Mall of Terror.
Okay.
My name.
The order. We are here today because prophecy is banned, and The Simpsons has obviously ignored that. So we need to see if they need to be banned as well.
Listen. Okay. I am the Simpsons representative, Matt Groening's son. Matthew Groening. The Simpsons, that's kind of my dad's thing. He's like, he has all these mind powers and he just like puts it in the writing of the show and he kind of can't control it. So like, can you really blame him?
Switch left.
Hello. There, little octopus. How is your day going?
Hey, it's going pretty good. Pretty good. I'm just an octopus swimming in the ocean, causing a commotion, because I am awesome.
yes, I've heard about you. You see, yeah. I have this plot. The scuba divers, they've had it too good. You gotta help me stop them, you know, and then I can eat. What? Come back, thank you. And then I can eat, and then you could also eat if that's what you're into.
Which left?
Before you butt in, that is when I saved the princess and I passed my chemistry exam.
Yeah, so it's quite odd that you said that you passed it, because I got information from all your teachers and they say you cheated and you will not be graduating night school.
Well, it was more like I passed it up, you know, like I had stuff to do.
Switch right.
Whoa, was that a good meal or what? Aren't you glad you are working with me?
I'm quite happy that I'm living here. Just, I think we don't need as many dead bodies. I think it's kind of, it's getting a bit hard to see. There's a lot of, like, floating people around. And you know what? My octopus pit children are feeling a bit down in their dumps.
I understand, but you see, I only drink the blood. I'm a simple vampire. I don't actually eat the bodies, and I can't just throw them into the pollution, because the humans go crazy when bodies wash on shore, you know?
I've been a nice guy, but I don't think I've been getting much out of this deal. You just show up into my octopus cave, and what do? I mean, what? I don't even know your name. You've just been sleeping on the sunken couch?
Switch right.
Now, Your Honor. I know some things were a bit out. Like when I told him, hey, you know, Trump become president, I don't really put that in there. But like, so far, no one's tried to block out the sun. That's a pretty cool thing. So, you know.
Sir, yes. Sir, we've been here for 8 hours. I am so tired. You're like, at the beginning, you mentioned that your dad has the art of prophecy. And that, like, that's illegal, as we established.
You know, what kind of society is it that we live in where people who are better than others are illegal? Sorry that my father was just naturally better than other people. Can you blame him for that?
Switch left. What
has he really done wrong?
Switch right.
And now, child, we come to the spookiest place of all, Sephora.
Sephora. What do you, I didn't know that was here.
Yes, they'll tell you how awful your skin is.
My skin?
Yes, and then they'll give you so many things to take care of your skin that you really don't do anything. But you'll be hundreds of dollars in debt by the time you leave.
I've got a bad credit score already, so like, I don't know, like, my skin, I feel like I exfoliate enough, I don't...
Which, right?
Tell you that you exfoliate too much!
So I'm not graduating after all I've done?
You know what, to be perfectly honest, today's been a very stressful day, and, come in. So I've decided to tell you this because you're super chivalrous. You know how to save stuff. So apparently we're not apparently qualified to let people graduate. And yeah, so that's kind of the issue right now. And I'm kind of freaking out. I was hoping your chivalrous attitude can, you know what, take us, get us out of here.
Which left? I mean, like...
Okay.
Oh, wow. Your skin is practically glowing now.
Which left?
Fine. You're innocent. Fine. Fine.
Switch left.
Listen, I know you kicked me out, but I brought you some fish to eat so that maybe I can stay.
I don't eat fish. I'm vegetarian. Oh. Come on, Terry. I learned your name, but that's not enough to make us okay.
See? Let's go.
Alright, folks. Next game we're going to see is called Superheroes. The way this game gets played off, there will be one person who's in danger who will then call upon a superhero. Now, when that superhero comes, they'll be, of course, made up, of course, so there's no trademark issues. They'll call that superhero, and then that superhero would need some help. So that superhero will call on the help of his superhero friends to come save the day. But they'll show up one at a time, and they can only appear once you describe who they are and their abilities. So this is your game, Superheroes. Ba 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 ba.
Oh, not the Wi-Fi again. This happens every day. All right, okay. Guess Professor Alarm Clock, Mr. Alarm Clock, myself will have to fix it. All right, let's look. This. Oh, okay, got it. I'll use my solar loud screaming to fix it. Maybe I'll shake something inside. It's not working. Maybe. Oh! Okay, I got it. Maybe if I try to shake it like I shake beds every day with my powers, with my hands, maybe it will work. It's not working. Oh my gosh, I totally got it. I will get Mr. Dance Attack to come in and help me. Oh, yes. Hey, Mr. Dance Attack?
I am here. It is I. Mr. Dance Attack!
Alright, well, I tried to fix the Wi-Fi router. Here, look at it. And, none of my powers were fixing it, so do you think you can try something?
Maybe I can intimidate it into working with my awesome dance moves.
Okay.
Is it working?
No, not really.
Huh. Well, that's the extent of my powers. Maybe we should call in another superhero.
Yeah.
I got it. We could call in my old friend, Mr. Speedman. He came in for a second. They ran right back out to see what he could get.
Oh, yeah, I know. Sorry, yeah.
Take the dishes. What do you want?
Our Wi-Fi's broken. Please help.
You know I can't fix Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi will never be fast.
Well,
I'll try.
Okay, here.
Maybe if I rapid punch it. Yeah, no, that doesn't work. I need to call in my friend, Captain Nielspor.
I am Captain Nielspor. Whatever that may be, I will unplug it and plug it back in with mind powers.
Okay.
Is the cable moving?
Wait, guys. I got it. Okay, so if Mr. Speed, if you run back in time to before Wi-Fi was created, and you have Neosporin on your back and Mr. Dance Attack on your back, then Mr. Dance Attack can challenge the creator in a dance battle, and then Neosporin
can win. Yes, we'll steal his manuals.
Come on, you guys gotta be fast. Come on, get over it.
Come on, let's go.
Wow, we're in like the 1970s. Whoa, it's like there's a person with crazy hair over there.
Bill Gates? Whoa, that's a really cool pool skirt.
I've always been a fan of Bill Gates.
Yeah.
Hold on, I need to grab my audio.
Bill Gates, inventor of the internet.
The creator's still asleep. This is my time to wake
up. Will you give me an autograph? Cool, thanks.
Oh, he's got some real...
Okay, right.
You need to wake up the creator with your alarm clock powers.
It's working, right? I know, kind of awesome.
Is he dead?
Wow, he's awake, I think. Mr. Internet Man.
I challenge you. With the dance-off for your manuals on the internet.
Look, this is the third time someone's asked for my files of this week, so you can just take them.
Brilliant!
All right.
Call it there.
Alrighty, this is it, y'all. 2 weeks left, including this week, which means the wins and losses are going to matter soon, so let's just have fun while we have it. Here's just a silly little way to end the show and to pick today's winner. So what do my captains got today? Okay, I want both of you to give motivational speeches to why people should eat their vegetables. Motivational speeches, eating vegetables. You guys can go at the same time, up to you. Ready? Go.
Okay, well, I mean, I started off living on one specific street. I just lived on that lane. My name's Eric, and this, of course, is...
My name is my name is Alberto, and my vegetables, they saved my life. I can't speak highly enough of them. It all started when my mom put an airplane in my mouth. Here comes the airplane with the
vegetables.
That
happened to me too. Wow, we should start doing motivational speeches together now.
We're so alike. Oh my gosh.
Wow, like Eric and Tim? I like this now.
Wow.
Vegetables.
Yeah.
Green.
You know what? They are now a motivational speaker team, which is exactly what we promote here in Jesters. But unfortunately, Jesters is in America, so I need to break up that team and pick a winner. You know what? Jonathan went for the Eric and Tim reference, which is a reference to other things. So I am going to give it to ATECH today. ATECH wins!
Guys, I hope you had a little bit of fun watching the show. If you need more information, which I know you will, go to Facebook, High School Jesters. Go to Instagram. Go to the website, highschooljesters.com. There's so much information there that you probably don't even realize is out there. So if you want to know what's going to happen in the playoffs, and if we can be back in person at some point, check out the website, Facebook, Instagram. Thank you, guys. We'll see you in the next show.